Hello, folks, and welcome to the Vertigo Tea Party and Let's Play Deus Ex Mankind Divided. Hop into the story here, gonna make a new game. We'll be playing Give Me Deus Ex Difficulty. It is the next to highest difficulty, the highest. I can't even play yet until you beat the game. Also, you die once and your save is gone, so we won't be doing that. So before we go any further, very quick note before we start. I wanted to mix this Let's Play up a little bit, so we're actually going to be playing Adam Jensen Total Bastard. Basically, I want to go in as the idea that this Adam Jensen, for whatever reason, is completely selfish, only cares about himself, and just likes being a jerk to other people. This might make us lose out on some side quests. This might cause some bad ending, or a bad ending, which probably will. But if anything else, I think it'll be amusing to watch and to play as just a complete jerk Adam Jensen. We'll see how it goes. I think it'll be fairly entertaining. I kind of played a jerk in the last one anyway, so it kind of fits. So just wanted to let you guys know that before we get started. Also, there is a video, a 12-minute recap video right here. I'm going to play it. However, I'm going to put an annotation and a link in the description below the video. So you can click that and it will skip ahead past that. I might even make it a second video. We'll see, but it will probably just skip it in this one. But those of you who want to watch it, just sit back and enjoy as we recap what happened from Deus Ex Human Revolution.
The year was 2027. Advances in biotechnology were helping people improve their physical and mental abilities to an amazing degree. Provided, of course, they had enough money. A new breed of people was emerging, half human, half machine. And in Detroit, at least, not everyone was happy to see it. I'd just landed a job as head of security at Seraph Industries, a cutting-edge biotech firm. David Seraph himself handpicked me for the job. Said he needed me to keep his people safe. My ex, Megan Reed, was one of them. Brilliant neuroscientist, Megan had found a way to make augmentation safe and affordable for everyone. All she had to do was present her research to Congress. But the night before her big meeting, my security measures failed. A team of Black Op mercenaries stormed into Seraph headquarters, massacring everyone in sight. Three of the mercs were heavily augmented walking tanks. Their mission? Take out Megan and her team. I tried to stop them, but their leader tossed me through a plate glass wall. Last thing I heard as his bullet slammed into my brain was Megan's dying scream. I should have died with her. Only I didn't. High-end, military-grade enhancements saved my life. The best augmentation Seraph's money could buy. It took me half a year to get a feel for her. Should have taken longer. But 6 months into my recovery, Seraph Industries was attacked again. This time, by a radical group of pro-human purists. Violent, militant, and fanatically opposed to human augmentation. They claimed to be members of Humanity Front, a non-profit organization that wanted the UN to limit biotechnology research. The thugs broke into Seraph's factory and found machinists working overtime on a top-secret military augment called the Typhoon. Seraph sent me to retrieve it. And when I did, I found one of the so-called purists next to it, wired with cerebral implants, trying to download its classified specs. Obviously, something more was going on. The Aug killed himself before I could question him. Seraph ordered me to dig deeper. So with the help of Frank Pritchard, Seraph's head of cybersecurity, I did. Turns out a second hacker had been controlling the Aug's actions from somewhere off-site. Pritchard and I tracked his signal to a secret FEMA internment camp in Detroit. The Black Op mercenaries were there. The same mercs who'd left me for dead 6 months before. Figured they'd try again when they saw me. Wasn't so easy for them this time. I took out the tank named Barrett, even got him to give me a new lead. A penthouse apartment in China. Of course, we both knew it would be a trap in the end. Hengxia Island, China. Home to a city so crowded, they had to build a second city on top of it. Trying to find clues in Hangzhou wouldn't be easy. Lucky for me, I wasn't alone. Farida Malik, Seraph Industries' ace pilot, had lived in Hangzhou before. A good person to have on your side. She knew enough about the place to get me around. Malik dropped me in the lower city, close to the penthouse Barrett had told me about. Belltower Associates, a private security firm under contract to the Chinese government, had agents tossing the suite when I arrived. Just not for the reason I'd been expecting. Turns out the man who lived there was a criminal hacker named Van Bruggen. The same hacker who'd been remotely controlling the AUG in Seraph's factory. Van Bruggen's panicked decision to force the man to commit suicide had been a mistake. Now his mercenary partners were gunning for him, and I needed to find him before they did. Locating Van Bruggen meant playing nice with the Triads, Hengsha's organized crime lords. They had the hacker holed up inside a low-rent capsule hotel. By the time I found him, Van Bruggen had no qualms giving up the woman who hired him. Zhao Yunru, president of the Taiyang Medical Corporation. According to Van Bruggen, Zhao wanted to monopolize the augmentation industry and had hired black op mercenaries to destabilize her competition. Seraph Industries was at the top of her list. To prove this, I needed to get inside TYM and grab a surveillance hologram off a server. I suspected Van Bruggen was hiding something when he told me this, but nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. Megan wasn't dead. She and her four best researchers had been kidnapped, spirited away somewhere while their kidnappers made it look like they were dead. Desperate to learn more, I confronted Zhao in her penthouse. She claimed to be a pawn in a bigger plan, and hinted at a group so powerful it controlled global interests at a whim. Then she slipped into a panic room and hit the alarm, forcing me to make a very quick exit. I figured Zhao was lying, but part of her confession made sense. David Seraph had been worried about his people. So worried, he'd required all of them to have subdermal locator devices surgically implanted. The GPLs would have been broadcasting the day of the attack. But Zhao sent a single call to Picus, the world's leader in global 24-hour satellite news, and turned those signals off. I needed to fly to Picus headquarters in Montreal if I wanted to learn more. Eliza Kassan, Picus Communications' First Lady of News. Malik thought I was reaching when I told her Eliza was involved in this. The world's most famous news anchor, working with a mercenary hit squad. But when I confronted Kassan in her office, she freely admitted to jamming Detroit's satellites the night Megan's team had been taken. Said she's just been following her commands. I suspected she wanted to say more. But black op mercenaries showed up, looking to shut us both down. And just like that, the Eliza I'd been talking to disappeared. The mercs were led by an augmented killer I'd crossed paths with twice before. Fedorova, a woman who'd made Silence her best friend. She waited for me to track Eliza's transmission to a secret server room underneath the Picus complex, then jumped me from behind. A deadly fight ensued. I made sure she never moved silently again. With Fedorova down, and no one left to keep Eliza quiet, she reappeared. Turns out Picus's First Lady of News wasn't a lady at all. She was a sophisticated AI program, engineered to monitor data streams and control what people believed. Eliza told me the mercs had brought in a Humanity Front doctor named Isaiah Sandoval, to remove the scientists' implanted tracking devices while Detroit's satellites were down. She also told me to speak to David Seraph if I wanted to learn more. By the time Malik and I got back to Detroit, tensions between normal and augmented citizens had reached a flashpoint. Riots were breaking out in several cities, and the UN was being urged to intervene. Seraph was trying hard to convince Hugh Darrow, the inventor turned philanthropist who'd once been a leading proponent of enhancement technologies, to help stop a possible regulatory vote. Seraph had a lot riding on Darrow. Megan's discovery would have given millions of people the chance to evolve beyond their normal human abilities, and at the same time, catapulted Seraph Industries to the top of the Fortune 500. According to Seraph, Megan's kidnappers knew this, and didn't want people evolving unless they controlled how it was done. He called his enemies Illuminati, and urged me to keep searching. Determined to do so, I tracked down Sandoval via America's most outspoken augmentation opponent, Bill Taggart, Sandoval's boss and founder of Humanity Front. Sandoval admitted to operating on Megan's team when I confronted him, but said he hadn't removed their GPLs. He'd merely switched them to a different frequency. Pritchard was able to trace one of the signals to China. Malik and I immediately took off in pursuit. Unfortunately, the Illuminati were one step ahead. Ambushed. Shot out of the sky by Bell Tower associates, seconds after entering Hengxia's airspace. Malik's piloting skills saved me. After a tense and bitter struggle, I escaped into Lower Hengxia. The tracking signal I was following led straight to the Triads, or more specifically, to the augmented arm of Tong Si-Hung, leader of a gang of augmentation harvesters. Tong said they'd taken the arm off a corpse, which Bell Tower had left at their door, meaning at least one of Seraph's scientists was dead. Maybe not the rest of them, though. Tong pointed me to a port used for human trafficking and helped me slip aboard a Bell Tower ship. It was sailing to Rifleman Bank Station, a military base in the South China Sea. Bell Tower was holding kidnapped civilians as prisoners there, and using them to perfect the Hiron Project, a human-computer interface that left most of its test subjects dead. My search for Megan would have ended then, if not for a mysterious ally named Quinn. In exchange for my help exposing Bell Tower, he slipped me aboard a second ship headed to Singapore, and an Illuminati-run biotech facility called Omega Ranch. Three of Seraph's scientists were there, forced by their captors to create a technology capable of remotely shutting down augmented abilities. Thanks to an emergency recall notice issued by the World Health Organization, millions of people all over the world already had the biochip installed. With the help of the scientists, I tracked Megan to a private section of the ranch. There, I ran into Yaron Namir, the walking tank who'd put a bullet in my brain the first time we met. He'd teamed up with Zhao and was hoping to catch me off guard. Their little ambush didn't work. I found Megan in a suite belonging to Hugh Darrow, the billionaire philanthropist who'd Seraph had called on for help. Darrow had convinced her to go along with the biochip plan by promising to sabotage the tech. As she was explaining this, Darrow appeared in a global broadcast, telling the world that augmentations would be the death of mankind. Then he activated the biochips to prove his point. All over the world, augmented people flew into a killing frenzy. Darrow had betrayed everyone, and it was up to me to set things right. To do it, I had to reach Panchaea, a massive installation in the Arctic Ocean. As I raced through corridors built by an all-augmented workforce, I saw death and destruction firsthand. By the time I shut down Darrow's broadcast, I knew the damage he'd done. Still, humanity's future remained unclear. How would the world react to this sabotage? Would people ever regain their faith in augmentations again? What would be the Illuminati's next move? Only time will give us the answers.
Wow, I just now realized how convoluted that story at the first one was. That was actually pretty useful to me, because I had forgotten a lot of that. Though I was rewatching my Let's Play a little bit ago. Anyway, now this is the beginning of the new game.
I once thought I could save the world. Now look at it.
You can tell because of the better graphics.
In yet another augmented terror attack, 251 passengers aboard Sista Airlines Flight 451 were killed. When an augmented passenger broke into the plane's cockpit and ruthlessly butchered its flight crew. Details recovered from the black box recorder suggest that the man may have been suffering flashbacks to the AUG incident. That horrible day 2 years ago when augmented people all over the world flew into a psychotic killing spree, causing the greatest loss of life in recent history.
Sometimes, you just have to let go and embrace what you've become.
Not gonna go all wonky on us now, Hansa, are ya?
Well, if I do, MacReady, I guarantee you'll never see it coming.
Jensen, am I gonna have a problem with you?
Looks like Hank Williams Jr.
Sir, no reason to assume you would.
Good, because you are the only augmented operative on this team, and I intend to make good use of you. Listen up, all of you. We got a sandstorm barreling down our ass, and we can't afford to make mistakes. We're going after this man, an arms dealer named Shepard. He's ex-Bell Tower, one of the Special Forces commanders who disappeared during the incident.
And he's come out of hiding. That cannot be good.
It's not. He's selling weapons and military-grade augments to terrorists. This is Aran Singh, the undercover agent who lured Shepard out of his hole. Best you see Interpol's got. But 3 years he's worked hard to get in tight with the Jinn, an Iraqi smuggling cartel that's infected the Eastern Hemisphere like a plague. Last week, our arms dealer sent a message to the Jinn, offering to sell them a shitload of black market merchandise dirt cheap. They told Singh to handle the buy.
They're not gonna like it when Interpol disrupts their party. Singh's cover really that good?
It is right now. We need to keep it that way. This is where the deal's going down.
Oh, nice.
A half-finished high-rise hotel that's been abandoned ever since the incident. It's not a pretty picture inside.
Let me guess. Most of the laborers were augmented with heavy-duty industrial rigs. So when the incident hit, and they all went schizo, things got gruesome real fast.
That's ableist.
No one, except for some homeless junkies, have been inside the place ever since.
So what's the
check your privilege.
Singh's meeting Shepard on the ground floor, inside the hotel's main atrium. He sent the bulk of his Jinn crew to the penthouse levels to secure a vantage point. I want MacReady's team to take up positions overlooking the atrium and make the arrest. Jensen, you're going in solo from the roof.
My objectives?
Keep the Jinn from joining the party. As far as we can tell, only one route connects the atrium to the penthouse level, a halfway decent elevator shaft, here. I want you to block access to it.
Fine. Just cut me loose.
Do you plan on relying solely on your augments for this one? I'd recommend taking a little hardware, just to be sure.
Technically, the augments are hardware, sir. Just throwing it out there. I don't want to be the grammar Nazi. Lethal? I'm not leaving my six exposed. Give me something lethal. All right, I'm not going to talk like that the whole time. Or non-lethal. Of course we're going lethal.
I'm not leaving my six exposed. Give me something lethal.
Your call, but Singh's undercover in all this.
So watch your fucking sights.
What about range? There's lots of wide spaces and high ceilings in there, but a number of tight and constrained rooms too.
So it's a crapshoot, really.
Distance combat rifle or short range weapon? Let's go with a rifle.
Well, I'm not looking to play dice with anyone in there. Give me something with distance.
Your call. Less chance of being seen and compromising Singh that way. One last thing, Jensen. Singh said the Jinn are using some sort of portable Wi-Fi device to boost communications. He's got a better chance of maintaining cover if you disable it.
I'll keep an eye out for it. But aren't we on the clock here? You said there's a sandstorm moving in.
There is, and we got the intel on this mission at the very last minute, so we're scrambling a little. If it comes to it, your number one priority is keeping the Jinn out of that atrium.
Copy that.
Time to put away your heavy thoughts, gentlemen. We're approaching the target building.
Starting my happy thoughts.
Let's do this.
Because people are gonna die. Hooray! Actually, when I saw that hotel at first, I thought there was like water coming down.
Engage Husk drives and descend to Angels 1-5.
Copy 1-4, Porcupine. We're down on the sand mat here. Turning on the cactus thrusters, over. Do over, dear Ranger. Parachutes are for pussies. Look at them hair physics. There's a reason he's got short hair. Oh, yes! It knew I unlocked that from the last game. He's fine. Sweet. Whoa, Typhoon ammo.
Team leader, this is Jensen. I'm on the roof.
Solid copy. Move into the building. The access route you need to block is at the far end of the penthouses. And keep in mind, the direct route might not be the easiest one.
Roger that.
MacReady will advise once his team is on the ground. Miller out.
All right. First of all, damn, this game looks good. Like, I was actually a little worried when I was looking at the benchmark testing. It was like, ah, the graphics are kind of funky. But, oh, wow, my mouse is on the screen? Oops. let me change the mouse sensitivity real quick. It's, like, through the roof. One second. Alrighty, I fixed it. If you have that same issue where the mouse cursor is showing up when you're, like, in this screen, just restart the game. Alright. Okay. Oh, I can pick up and throw shit. That's good. View entry. Oh, okay, this shows your control scheme. Okay. How far can I jump? Icarus strike. Q to strike. Okay. Some gameplay options I might be changing a little bit later on. For example, there's an option to hide your HUD after a few seconds of inactivity. I really like that idea. I like having a nice clean HUD most of the time unless I absolutely need to see it. So we'll probably be doing that. We'll be messing with some stuff. As far as gameplay style, I'm obviously, again, gonna play big asshole, total jerk, evil, if you will, playthrough. Many dark side points will be gained. As far as just combat, I will probably, you know, try to take as many people out stealth as possible. And then once the shit hits the fan, I'm just gonna, you know, go with it. I'm not gonna be like, oh no, I wanted to do a silent killer assassin playthrough. We will not be doing that. Okay, here's somebody up there. A ladder. Okay. Alright. Now I'm gonna...
Jensen, we're moving through... Oh, fuck!
What's wrong?
The djinn have got a few Jennies up and running. We're gonna have to hack keypads.
Should enjoy it, MacReady. They have colors and shapes. Just remember, red means bad.
Fuck you.
See, he's already asshole. I don't gotta do anything. The only thing I'm concerned with, though, is, like, with this telling me all the stuff that I can move, like, I want to know what a chest looks like. I don't want to skip chests because I'm like, ah, that just means I can throw it. Game does look phenomenal, though, by the way. I know you don't really appreciate that on YouTube because, well, it's YouTube. Yeah, see, I thought that was, like, water rushing down. That's why I was like, oh, cool, when it first opened up. Throw it. Yeah. Except we had all my mods from the last game. Because I had the strength, I had the slow fall. Oh. God damn it. Wow, this guy's been dead a while. Oh, well, 2 years, I guess. Can I, I like the way he throws it. It's an empty cardboard box. Don't ham it up there, Adam. Okay. Hold space and move forward to grab a high ledge. It didn't seem like he even needed it. He's got the high jump too. Nice. So at what point do we get hit with like a super mega imp and lose our abilities? And by imp, I mean EMP, not IMP. Not playing a warlock here. And if we were, we should be using a succubus. Press B to open the augmentation wheel. To equip smart vision, press middle mouse button to assign it and exit the augmentation wheel. So I'm going to guess this is smart vision. Ah, okay. Interesting. Ah, Batman Vision. Every poor developer ever now is any kind of vision enhancement change type thing like this is always going to be called Batman Vision. Oops. Sorry, buddy. Respect in the den. God, worthless. Well, I would respect them if they had some shit. Tread. See, that's what I'm talking about. Bring some money to work. Nothing even in the lockers. Christ. Whoa. Oh, okay. I'm like, do I have to shoot it at those points? Shoot it with our finger and fist. That isn't gonna make sense, actually. Quick inventory. Let's see what this is real quick. Quick inventory allows you to access items on the fly. Tab to access the inventory. Select an item and press the corresponding number key to assign number to the slots. Okay. Pressing the keyboard key link to a slot instantly equips. Cool. Ah, so we can do one. Okay, cool. What is this? I right click it? Examine. Just curious what it does. Recover health. Half of the health meter. Okay, that's all I need. Frag grenades. Okay, cool. I don't want to spend too much early time looking at instructions and all that shit. I'll fiddle with that off camera once we finish our first video. Restore power to the keypad. Okay, this is just our mission briefing. Okay. Can't go. Oh, wait. Yes, we can. Oh. Thought maybe I could bust it open. I don't know what our melee attack is. I don't even know if that's enough to break it. What do you got over here? Oh, God. Come on. You can make that. That, his super high jump is throwing me off. I'm a basketball player. Actually, I don't even know if they probably would allow that. Alright, let's see what this actually says. A route to the building has been blocked. Electrically operated doors. I need to find a way to restore power so I can use the keypad to open it. Better search the area. Alright. I really feel. Yeah, there we go. There'd be a way up here. Anything of interest over here? This is going to be a, just so you know, a fairly slow-paced game. Watching my old video, though, I took way too much time doing a lot of things, or at least recording a lot. So what I'm going to do this time, things like hacking mini games and reading stuff, like the things we find, the notepads, all that, I'll leave them on the screen for a second so that you guys can read them. But I'm not going to just read them all off unless they look important. As far as hacking games, I'll show them like a couple times, but I'm not going to show every attack hack. In fact, I'm not going to show most hacking. Most likely. Let's not go through there. Even though I feel like I should be like Godzilla and electricity should give me strength. Because I'm a robot man. Robot man. All right. This is the keypad, I'm guessing, from the name keypad. See, hack. Okay, security rating 1. Whoa, oh Jesus. Okay, this is a little different. We're definitely going to want to read this. So the circle, well, I think it's just the graphics are different. Start from the blue IO port and capture all the green registries. We got to get all greens. Navigate the system by capturing nodes using the C button or by using the mouse to click capture. Higher rated nodes take longer to capture and have higher detection percentages. If detected, you will have limited time to complete before you get locked out. Wow, I can't talk today. Use the mouse to navigate between nodes. Ah, press C to capture. Okay, this is a little different. It was a little sloppy, I feel like.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
Can I fortify? Yes. Yeah, we'll trace back to the IO port. Capture something, something, something. So fortifying makes it so that their traceback attempt takes longer. That I do remember. The registry has been breached. The device has been unlocked. Yeah, I imagine that one was going to be pretty easy. Script kitty, hooray! I can go DDoS something now. All right, tutorial mode. Follow the green holograms to receive tutorial instructions about various game mechanics. Experiment without any consequences. You can reset or exit at any time. Learn about moving to cover, cover swapping, rounding corners, vaulting over, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's do that real quick. That's cool that they have this though, that they have it separate so you can just kind of mess with it. Press F to take cover. Aim at the next cover, or the cover next to the green hologram, and press space to move from your current cover to the next. Man, I am butchering the reading today, aren't I? Hold the movement key in the direction of the green hologram and press space to roll. Oh, no, okay. Hold on. Oh, you just have to look. Oh, I bet if you, okay, good. So you don't really have to look at it. You can also, like, hit left and space at the same time. Or well, D in space, you know what I mean. Can I do forward and or space hold? Ah, okay, that goes around the corner. Nice. Is it actually wanting me to do something specific? Okay, so, all right, space again takes me off. Oops. Aim at the next cover and press space to vault over. I wonder if you can do that with keys. Oh, that's just vaulted over. Oops. Wrong key. Aim at the next green hologram and press space to run out of cover and back into first person. Ah, that's interesting. You want to exit or reset? Let's exit. That's a cool mode. I really like that. That's really neat. That is pretty damn cool. As I immediately screw it up. God damn it. You moron. Did you learn nothing? I want to silently assassinate the shit out of this guy. Whoa. How you doing? He's fine. Takedowns. Let's go ahead and read this real fast. Takedowns have an energy cost. They are not available if the minimal energy threshold is not full. Lethal takedowns are more noisy and run a higher risk of creating disturbances, but they completely neutralize an NPC. Non-lethal are less noisy, so the risk of disturbance is lower. However, NPCs can eventually be woken up. Well, he's not going to be waking this asshole up anytime soon. The inventory screen is a little strange. Is that just me? All right. So let's drag this jackass. All right, high five. You killed me. Good job, bro. No hard feelings. Nope, don't look this way. Ah, shit. You know what? We're gonna put you here. You're fine. Alright, bye! Yeah, me too. I wanna see this other guy. Son of a... I know there's like one other person over here. Yep, there we are. What if I can do a double takedown yet? Probably not. Damn it, I was hoping. Now he's just going over. I want to take out this other. Kalina ninhi hadhihi safqa wa nitla' min hun. No, no, no. You didn't see shit. Up the nose. Those bullet goes. All right. No problem. However, there was a guy over here that's still alive. We didn't want that. He might have heard something. Cover system is pretty cool. So far. There was a guy over here, right? I'm not crazy. There actually was a person over here who needs to be killed. Take the high road. It's always the best road. Unless you mean in the moral sense, then screw that noise. Adam Jensen gotta get paid, baby. Don't see anything over there, so let's move on. Because normally I'm going to be taking my time a lot. Making sure. Ooh. Alright, so that's one. Looks like a Home Depot cooler. That's one kind of device or container that has stuff within it. But I will be taking my time. Not going to be rushing this. I'm going to try to cut out the really boring parts again. Like just the hacking and any backtracking I do, that kind of thing, that will be cut. But for the most part, this is a full Let's Play. And I hope you guys stick around. I hope you guys enjoy. As always, I'm not wrapping up right now, but just kind of throwing some stuff out here. But if you guys, any commentary you want to give me back, positive, negative, it's all good. Make sure to leave that in the comments below. Hopefully the sound and everything should be fine. I checked everything before we started recording. All that good stuff. But yeah, I'm actually pretty excited about this. I liked Human Revolution, but I didn't think... Oh, okay, I see. We're looping around now. Gotcha. I didn't think it was great. The energy system in that game was total ass. I've heard it's a lot better in this game. We'll be finding that out soon enough. I see the energy at the bottom left.
Jensen, Mac.
Hi.
Listen up. Doppler shows that sandstorm's moving in fast. It's big, and it's gonna hit us hard.
God, I hate the fucking desert. Confirm visual?
I can.
God, I hate fucking Darude.
Copy that.
Solid copy.
God, that copy is so solid. I'm getting the solidest copy right now. Stun gun ammo. That's going straight to the vendor. Open it more should have really been the option. It's not very good lockers, seeing as how they're not like, hell yeah. That's how I want to lockpick. That's how I want to hack too with my fists. Beer case? Well, these must have been union workers. Heyo. Okay. Okay, but yeah, I'm looking forward to this game. I feel like the energy system, like I said, I've heard that they've kind of learned that that system, frankly, was a butt sack. Oh, whoops. Damn it. I love that throw. Eh. It looked like he's like shopping during Black Friday, not throwing a light object. All right, so truth time. I wasn't quite sure where we're supposed to go. Penthouses. Hell yeah, penthouses. I'm sure those are finished and look nice. I have actually seen these where they put the cloth up in the elevator. It was very weird and they smelled bad. I think that was less to do with the method and more the fact that they used nasty throwaway horse blankets. Tutorial mode. Sure. We'll blow through this pretty quick. Oh, whoops, damn it. Keep hitting E to F4 to activate the glass shield cloaking augmentation. F4. Wow. Interesting. I did that, so I assume you just... Oh, okay, right, gotcha. It's kind of hard to see where that line goes because you're in my way tutorial. F1 to activate the leg silencer augmentation. Oh, interesting. Where's the next? I guess I don't even have to really crawl. Oh, Beast the Hologram, gotcha. Well, Hold right mouse button while aiming at an NPC to use the mark tracker augmentation. Oh, okay. Ah, so it's mark on like in Metal Gear.
Otacon.
Press E to pick up an object and left mouse button. This bucket. Don't take my buckets. Eh. Oh, did we run out of energy? Or? About to mark it with my goddamn bullets. Oh. Keep trying to melee. Man, this sensitivity thing, hopefully they fix that. Like, it's... I literally have the mouse sensitivity right now set to... Set to, 0%. 0%. Where's the other guy? Oh. Damn it, I keep trying to press E to throw, because that's how you do the normal people. Am I, where's the, okay, I see him. Oh, okay. That's all they wanted to show. Gotcha. All right, so it's F keys. That should be easy enough to remember. You son of a bitch. That extra black screen, kind of weird. Good night. Sleep type, etc. Credit chips, hell yeah. If you didn't want to die, you shouldn't have came into work today. Don't even die at those bodies. Throw the handsaw at them. That should just kill them. Okay, that toolbox looks too much like the lootable chest that we saw earlier. Oh, that's, is that where we came in? Hell yeah. Well, I mean, hell no, that's not where you came in. Hello. That's where we came in. Goodies? Yes. Shinies, yes. Oh, come on, game. I know this is just a tutorial area, but... Fine. Butthole game. I went out of my way to find secrets, and you give me no secrets. This is a very carrot-stick scenario here. You need to feed me the carrots. Instead of just hitting me with a stick. I don't know. That analogy fell apart really fast. Let's move on. That. Looking good, son. I like that look on you. The dead one. Okay, it's dead space all of a sudden.
Good. There is too much riding on this deal. Last thing we need is the comms breaking down.
Okay. Yes.
McCready, how you making out?
Slower than expected. It's like someone's tilled a fucking cemetery down here.
His lips are chafed.
When the shit hit the fan in 27, the rush must have been for the stairs. There's corpses everywhere.
Damn it. I hate when they have it so that an NPC's talking and if you keep moving, it screws it up. I hate that. That's why half the time I just sit there whenever there's cinematics that go on. V to open the quick inventory. Ah, okay. V. Press to open a hypostim injector to boost the health meter. How about I just find it? Oh, it's over here. Okay.
The thing we need is the comms breaking down.
Oops, wrong button. Press or hold G to throw grenades. Ah, okay. Oh, whoa, I don't know if he needs all that. Nice. You sound like that guy's below me, but I don't. Wait, what? Wasn't the green guy there? I'll say green for grenades. That should be easy enough to know. I like the little training curtain as well. Whoa. All right, let's just go down here and murder this guy. Surprise! You're fine. F2 to do the typhoon. Happy birthday! Probably would have been better if I killed that guy with it. Oh, okay, it's saying I have two Typhoon left, right. Gotcha. Okay, cool, that was a quick one.
McCree, how you making out?
Slower than expected.
His lips are still chafed.
Cemetery down here.
See, the joke's funnier.
When the shit hit the fan in 27, the rush must have been for the stairs. There's corpses everywhere. A lot of your cousins are here too, Jensen. You want me to grab you any spare parts?
No parts, but I take mine with cream and two sugars while you're asking.
Haha, everybody's a prick. I just casually murders people now. It's like, eh, whatever. People die every day. Granted, more often when I'm around, but while those guys are scattering to find the killer, I'm gonna look for the real killer. Have you seen him around? This guy looks fairly guilty. He did have a gun on him. Oh, I see you guys. Yep, I see you. Come on around. Good job, detective. We found him. Take a good, well-earned rest, son. We'll ship you right back to your mama. I'll deliver you myself. I needed to go over there anyway. Heyo. All right. Let's get off fat jokes. Wait, that wasn't even making sense. Damn it. These augments, they're messing up my mind. Duct tape? I figured you should grab that. We might need that later. What's the map looking like? The other map, there we go. Yeah, let's look over here. We might find stuff, and God knows I like to find stuff. Oh, I see. Right. That's the vet we came up and around, and we found those people murdered. Who would do such a thing? Somebody with giant blade arms, it looks like. Probably someone very attractive and smart. I can tell by the depth of the footprints that he had to have had a large penis. Over.
Jensen, what's your 20?
Johnson.
Working my way through the penthouses.
Remember to keep an eye out for the Jin's communications booster. If you can, disable it.
Roger that.
Kill everybody I find. Roger that, sir. Vaulting over is not really what I want to do here. Let's go around. I could probably jump down there and come around. Oh, wait a minute. What? There is a... What? Am I going crazy here? No, you're not. I was like, I know there was another way. One thing they said they focused on with this game is making sure there's multiple ways to do quests, not just, like, kill or stealth. But also, like, making the map such that there's multiple paths. Hello. Take my spot. I'm tired. My legs are pain and hurting. A lot of ammo. That's cool. But, yeah, hopefully that actually turns out to be the case. Where there's multiple paths to go. It already seemed kind of like that's true. Talking to yourself is really sad. No. Let's not do that. Let's not do that at all. That whole, I know we're enemies and you killed me, but I'm still a human. And at this minute, I realize, I'm like, nope, nope, just do the thing where you poop your pants and go ahead and pass on over to the next life. Morzimer Pilsner. Oh, great, we can get hammered. Super. Damn. I was trying to think what that's meant, trying to make me think of. Throwing his hands out. Jake, the hokey pokey, is that it? Throw your hand, no, that's you, throw your hips out? No, that's what old people do a lot. Nah, well. Buddy, okay, now that's where we were. So, of you guys watching this, I'm curious, how many of you have it? Are you gonna get this game? You already have it. What is your deal? Seriously, you. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. You got a problem. Your implantable breather prevents gas damage. Oh, prevents. Oh, okay. First, I thought it said like use the sweet. Give me that traveler XP. That's using energy, isn't it? It sure is. So we probably should find a way out of here fairly soon. There's a ceiling ladder. Oh, here we go. I want to know how energy regen is going to work in this game. Because like I said, that was definitely one of the main issues I had last one. Oh, you need to get a haircut like your do is sticking out. It's gonna give us away. Can I, Come on, nope. What, give me? Damn it! I can't pick this stuff up, but I can pick up a refrigerator. But that bucket, oh no. Well, that's good. They kept his little dance in. His little pee-pee dance. Guy looks paranoid. Why are you so paranoid? Just come over here. Let's have a drink. Talk this through. You know, you built a wonderful world. It's a shame you have to use so much violence. I agree. Now fucking die and shut up. That was the unconscious move, right? That's the one that just knocks him unconscious. He's fine. Okie doke. I bet this would be really interesting to play through, like stealth. Complete stealth. No, not being spotted ever. I keep forgetting to do the right click thing. Honestly, partially because I don't feel I need to. I'm gonna check over here first. I feel like I've cleared this area, though. By the way, if you're new around here, first of all, welcome. Second of all, apologies in advance that my memory is total crap. Because I could have been here like 2 seconds ago and I'll be like, I've never been in this location in my life. You wanna get up there, Adam? Feels like you're good at extremes. But the lower end, not so much. Oh, okay. That's right. So I want to get over there to that jackass. I see events. Huh? Ah, you know what? Let's do that. I want to take the person who's above first. I'm going to like do it right as he turns around. And let's quietly, and most importantly, humanely, pick out this guard. Nice haircut, hippie. Just leave high school? What the hell? I don't know how those guys are even gonna think about coming over. That right click thing's not working. Maybe because they're already flagged? I don't know. Wonder if these guys can climb ladders or not. I see you. Oh, see, now he's marked. That's weird. That took a while. I want to take out the other guy that's over there. He doesn't seem to turn around.
Listen up, everyone.
Hey, I'm busy.
Chang's hacked into the Jin's radio signal. Checking the patch now.
He's got the 80 station over.
Any second.
Khalil, الراجل اللي هيبقى علينا الحاجات جايك من شوية. روح قول لبقيه الناس ان انا هعصلكم وخليكم يعني منتظرين.
Patch is clean.
Solid copy.
Good. I'll repatch us once the deal kicks off.
Hope this is not actually timed, because he is probably gonna die. Hey, where'd that one guy go? Seriously, wasn't there another guy over here? Okay, for real, I'm like freaking out now. Well, I'm not freaking out, let's see. Fine. We can drop him. Whoop. Take these guys. Where's the other dude? Come on, I want you to go to the right. God damn it. I knew as soon as I finally got unhinged. There's another dude over there too. So that's why you would want it. Hello. I really wish you would drag them behind. Just a note, that does not explode that easily. What's that noise? Not even worth a bullet. Short bursts. Oh shit. There's actually a decent amount of people here. Hiding behind glass. Didn't work for you. Oh shit. Ah, damn it. Ah, and I forgot the F5's quick save too. Yes. Thank you. Yeah, I totally forgot to F5 save. Hopefully it actually saved a decent spot. If not, I'll get back to where. Oh, god damn. Like, it saved right in the middle of me running over there. Alright, let's do this again. Yeah, I feel the same way.
What are you?
Nope. Ah, shit, I can't. Oh, I must have just got the energy. Here, get over here. Out of the way. You got lucky, son, that I ran out of energy to murder you. I'm too tired to kill you. I'm gonna try to figure out how I'm gonna have to do this video. Another intro section would be quite this long. Might split it up into two. We'll figure it out. He's got a ways to come. Did he actually see something? I don't think. Wasn't there some other attack that I can do? I could do a drop. Damn it. Of course, everything's. What are you talking to? Freaking nerds. You that lonely? You gotta talk to yourself? Seriously? I think there's another guy on the side. Nope. You sure found me. Quick. Whoa. Okay. Yeah, all right. We don't need to take our time. As soon as we die, we can reload. So it looks like I'm going to have to start scouting out a little bit better to make sure that doesn't happen. I also forgot the quick save yet. Didn't you? Weirdo. Keep quiet, please. Thank you. Honestly, I've never liked the whole idea that, oh, killing them is louder. I've always thought that was silly. I mean, they had to balance it somehow, I guess. Because otherwise, like, why would you not just murder everyone? I mean, other than dumb moral reasons. Oh! This is gonna smart. Oh, what? What is it with this guy? Why do you want to keep knocking this one unconscious? Why is your moral compass always pointing to unconscious beatdown for him? I thought I had enough energy to kill there. Alright. Now let's F5. Quick save. So glad that's standard now. Alright, so this time we actually want this. What are you looking around for? There's nobody dead and looted? And definitely not one guy unconscious.
This is taking forever.
Yeah, it is. Kinda is. So yeah, it looks like your energy is still limited. Insofar as, like, how much it will regenerate. Ah, for fuck's sake. Just barely saw me. Frick. We might back out. Ooh, cooler. Nope. Yeah, take it. There's that. Okay, there's two. There you go. Oh, shit. I'm blown away. Good job, 80s. There's at least one more down there. Jesus. Accuracy on this thing is a butt sack. No, he's taking a nap. He's stoned. There's nobody over here. I don't know what you're looking at. That damn smoke. I loved you! Alright, there's still one guy alive. Yep. There he is. Come on around. I got him. He's deader than shit. Ah, shit. Yeah, about that. All right, that was a little bit smoother. Pretty sure they're all dead. So yeah, that's what I mean when I say, like, well, you know, if the stealth approach fails, we'll do it again. It's a me, Adam Jensen. I got a machine pistol ammo and shit to start a goddamn shop. Alright. Let's go back. Hey, thanks. What's in your wallet? Future moon bucks. Future bucks. Let's just call them future bucks. I forgot to do something over here. There we go. Oh, nope. Wrong guy. There we go. Now our job here's done. Ooh. Newspaper. So again, this kind of stuff I'm not going to read. I will keep it up on screen for like a few seconds. Is that Mitt Romney? Anyway, I'll keep it up so you guys can see it. So if you want to pause the video to read this stuff, you can. But I'm not going to read it just because, like I said, I don't know. Well, any more than I'm doing. Actually, if I'm boring you, you probably have stopped watching already. So you wouldn't even hear me say that. But you get the point. I actually do want to read them afterwards. And if I wasn't lazy, what I would do is like pause it, turn off recording, read it, and then come back. But then later I have to edit it together and blah, blah, blah. Who wants to do that? Ooh, free arm. Oh, nice. Hiding stuff in between crates. Wily little devils. All right, let's head on over. That's another thing I'll probably end up cutting out a lot of, by the way. I try to be very thorough with rooms, like checking for items. What I'll probably end up doing at some point is like, okay, I've cleared this room of enemies. I'm gonna go through and check it for items, but I'll do that off camera. Like, I'll cut that out. Because again, I don't really think there's any value added to watching me loot. I mean, unless there's like something specific I wanna talk about while I do it. Otherwise, not gonna bother. Let's see, exhibition. Okay, so that's where you want to go, so this is where you will go. Because you wanna look for stuff. But I am more interested in this game than I really think I should, because again, Human Revolution, I forget what I ended up giving it in my off-the-cuff review. Probably something like a 6.5, 7. Just because like the energy system was so bad. Another thing I didn't like was the NPCs didn't really seem to react to what you did a lot. For example, your boss in one mission tells you to go to a cop shop. Excuse me. To go to a cop shop and you have to do something there. I forget what it is. And he specifically says something like, you know, hey, they're cops. You know, don't go on a murdering rampage or anything. You know, that would be insane to kill a bunch of cops. And I'd have to deal with the blowback and blah, 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 blah. So when I did the mission, of course, I killed everybody in there. Cops, innocent bystanders, janitors, nobody was safe from Adam Jensen. And he did not say a single thing to me when I came back. That's the same newspaper with Mitt Romney, blonde Mitt Romney. Yes, that is the alternate universe version of Mitt Romney. So again, with these books, I also won't read these. I will keep them on screen for a second so you guys can pause and then read. Otherwise, just move on. I do like that they put that stuff in. And again, if I was not let's playing this, I would unquestionably do it. Is it me or does it seem odd? It's very sensitive on selecting the lockers. Maybe I'm just not. I had to point right at the where you open it and not the locker itself, if that makes sense. Maybe that's what's going on. Good amount of areas to explore though, that's cool. I'm really curious about this energy thing. It's bothering me that it hasn't regenerated all the way. Because that was the problem with the energy system in the last game was, like, you could have, you know, 4 or 5 pips worth of energy, but it would only regenerate the first one. And to regenerate the rest, you had to carry around candy bars and, like, slam candy bars. As awesome and delicious as that sounds, especially since I'm, like, been watching what I eat. It was annoying. Ah. secret passage, sort of. Okay. I mean, that's where we just were.
Jensen, we're inside the atrium, taking up positions on the terraces. What's your 20?
Still moving.
Well, hurry the fuck up. Enemy helo is inbound and this sandstorm's getting close. You get that comms booster disabled?
Negative. Didn't find it.
Well, you better hope Singh's cover stays intact. Otherwise, you'll be answering to me.
Oh, shit. Wait a minute. I wonder if I can find that still. Hey, speaking of cutting things out, I'm actually going to see if I can't find it real quick. And I'll pick you guys up if I find it. Otherwise, we'll make progress. Alright, I found another thing here. Like, where we got into some of our first fights. There was two grates. I actually didn't notice this one. This one was breakable. Another grate over here. One's not breakable. And this just comes... Oh, well, actually, you know what? This looks like it's probably it. Yeah, there we go.
Miller, I've disabled the Jin's comms booster. Should make it harder for them to listen in on the deal.
Good work. With luck, Singh's cover will still be intact when this is over.
Roger that. Moving on to primary target now.
Ha! And it was right by where this book was, too. Brilliant. Bloody brilliant. You're a genius. Alright, I'm gonna get back to where I was, pick you guys up there. Okey-doke. Man, they are in love with this whole, like, hot dog looking light system in this game, aren't they? They were in the last one too, right? They used that, like, fluorescent bulb shaped a lot in that game, right? Also, I did make some UI changes. Remember how I said I wanted to turn some of that fade on and off stuff? I went ahead and turned it on for everything. I don't know if it's really going to work for everything, but, you know, we'll try it out. Credit chip. Yes, please. I also found some extra ammo, and I wasted a Typhoon ammo. So that was pretty cool. Alright, let's try hacking this again. Advanced hacking. Ooh. The goal of a trace is to reach your entry point. The goal of a trace is to reach your entry point, the blue I.O. port. In other words, when you trigger the alarm, that's where they have to get to. You can slow the process by fortifying capture node. Okay, we talked about that already. All right. Is it me or is this interface a little bit clunkier? Let's go ahead and fortify.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
It's hard for me to tell where I can actually go, to be honest. But I'm fortifying all these as well. Like, really hard. And it's worth it to capture as many as you can because you can get, like, extra experience and stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and just capture that. Because we have plenty of time,
so. Granted.
At least I think so. Yeah, that interface seems a little messy. Is it me? Maybe it's just me, but the... I mean, well, I would say the old interface, without question, is cleaner. But this one's just harder for me to read, which, of course, to be fair, you know, part of that could just be because I'm trying to get used to it, right? Oh, we walked into a cinematic. They're all unconscious, boss.
Panos access route secure. Jin shouldn't be a problem. Over.
Copy that.
About fucking time. Enemy helo sighted.
Those guys really need to watch their tone with me.
All right, strike force. Position and hold.
Strike one. In position.
Strike two. All set.
Strike three.
Yeah.
Strike four. In position and holding, boss. Eyes up. Safety's off, guys.
Yeah, no shit, brown nose.
Watch your fucking mouth, Halliday.
Both of you, shut up. Five in position.
Everybody, stay sharp. Singh's got eyes on Shepard. Patching you in now. Target's in the AO. Remember, Singh's down there, so watch your fire.
You got balls, Singh. Executing a boy with a sandstorm on her ass.
I cannot take credit for Mother Nature, mister.
You can call me Shepard.
How biblical. Are these the weapons?
The orgs.
Damn it, they're just arms.
They're getting harder to come by. Guns are still on the chopper. Show me the cash quick and we'll...
What the?
It's Watch Dogs.
The park has been crashed. Shepard is dead.
What? Yeah.
By who? What's going on?
Are we not watching this happen?
This isn't the djinn. Repeat, it's not the djinn. They're after the weapons. Open fire! Open fire!
Weapons free! Open up!
You guys are watching what's happening.
Negative. We're under heavy fire down here. We can't let that chopper take off, Jensen.
I got it.
Theoretically. All right.
This is bad! They're closing in! We're gonna lose Singh! Jensen, I can't reach him!
I don't know if that does anything, but... Oh, hey, sweet. Merciful soul my ass.
Jensen, this sandstorm might have just bought us some time, but you need to disable that chopper.
Copy that.
What was that? Oh, double takedown. Nice. Don't want them waking up. Gotta get their weapons. There's two down here. Oh, I couldn't fall far enough. Oh, god damn it. Oh! I died so quick. I was hoping he would quickly hop over that so I could do the one thing. The AE blast thingy, what's its? Icarus strike, whatever. Well, that was going smoothly until I screwed it up at the end.
This is bad! They're closing in! We're gonna lose Singh! Jensen, I can't reach him!
I want this battle rifle. Is this, Oh no, I don't have to drag it down there. Just have to press 2. I have to drop it, then I press 2. Nice. Maybe not a great time to be trying this weapon out, but...
Jensen!
God damn it, stop moving!
Might have just bought us some time, but you need to disable that chopper!
Copy that.
Tell Darude to keep playing, sir! Okay, we only had one bullet. One bullet. Frick. Alright, so maybe use that weapon later. No, goddammit, Jensen. Not the box, you jackass. Whoa! Let our health get back. Oh shit. Wait, how the hell do you see me? Oh wow. Okay, so the sandstorm apparently is completely useless insofar as giving us cover. All right, so we're probably going to end up using this game's candy bars, which in this game, they just changed the graphic and the name so that they're called like, what are they? Nope, fuck off. Bio cells. They're candy bars.
Jensen,
they give you energy.
Might have just bought us some time, but you need to disable that chopper.
Copy that.
I like he's like, seems like I heard somebody shooting at me. It's like, yes. It's so weird that this vision, like, changes your hearing, dude. That's so bizarre. Ugh. Oh, I keep forgetting their goddamn... Their fucking, Adam? Hello? There we go. Yeah, it's weird how it's everything is muffled. Fuck off, piece of shit. Alright, let's use another candy bar. So I can actually fucking see.
Enemy positions are cleared. Strike force, tombstone that fucking chopper, please.
Hold on, let me loot a bunch of shit first. Let me save it a new slot. Wow. I had to do that repeatedly. That was super annoying. Hopefully it actually lets us keep this stuff. Yeah, you guys tombstone that, whatever. I'm gonna be stealing shit. Well, not stealing, because they're dead. But yeah, already not a fan of this energy system. We'll see. If we get chances to upgrade it, though, we definitely will be doing that. Because I do not want to be chugging energy bars like in the last game. Because that shit got old really fast. Ooh, is that another one? Hell yeah. Oh, give me. Thank you. No survivors.
Enemy positions are cleared. Strike force, tombstone that fucking chopper, please.
Yeah, they're working on it. I hate I can't see the guns like this. At least I don't think so. What the hell is this?
Jensen, step it up. That chopper's about to take off.
Oh, it just... Oh. How does anybody know? Serious gold markings have killed the arms dealer. They're trying to blah blah blah. I need to ground the chopper. But shoot it or?
Jensen, we're out of time here. It's now or never. You've got to stop that chopper.
Do I talk to him? Because he's marked. No. I mean, they're shooting it. All right, well, maybe I just do this. There we go. That works.
Oh, shit.
Didn't you want me to do that? You just said ground the chopper.
No,
that thing is grounded as fuck.
Repeat, choppers.
Grounded as fuck. Yes, that's what I just said. Oh, damn it. Yeah, I like Sandstorm as much as anybody else, but I think... We can take a track off repeat. Things just got weird.
Artificial eyes to prosthetic limbs.
From molecular size computers.
Human controlled evolution available to all.
Well, at least we can see, sort of. We can rebuild him again. Replace all his limbs with grenades. Ghost. Not quite, but...
Shanghai, Los Angeles.
Oh, I got two achievements. I think you guys can't see that for some reason. It gave me the ghost achievement. I guess because there were no witnesses. I also got an achievement for saving Singh.
Czech Republic leads a growing list of countries calling for the relocation of its augmented citizens.
That's always worked out well, and never looked back with on with shame.
This is retribution for a tragedy we cannot control.
Mechanical apartheid? Apart? You know what I'm saying. Lock up all the cars. They really went hard on the angel redemption.
Let it happen again.
Jesus thing, didn't they? Mankind divided. Well, that part sucked my ass though. That bullshit with the sand. That'll give us some time. I guess theoretically it couldn't take off. Maybe that's what they mean by it was helping them? I don't know. It really wasn't, though.
What have the events in Dubai cost us?
They knew the risks.
How many assets did we lose?
All of them. This sandstorm didn't help.
The
the mission was a success.
Clearly, your scale of success is a generous one. However, the erratic nature of the attack could work to our advantage. Interpol will be confused for weeks, and with our continued guidance, the people will come round eventually. We are all in this for the long game, after all.
That's never changed.
You think so? Do I need to remind you all how far we have veered off course? The Og incident has caused a schism in society. Things are worse than we projected, and growing more unstable every day. This will not be tolerated. To ensure the success of our vision, the disruptive elements must be excised.
No one here disagrees with you. But let me fly to New York and I will personally evaluate the situation. We may already have the votes we need to ensure that the Human Restoration Act passes.
Very well. Stanton, you accompany. We may need to exert financial as well as political pressure to silence anyone opposed. Proceed. Elizabeth, I'll contact you later.
It won't succeed, Lucius, even with Dowd's money. You know what Rand will find in New York?
Go Rand Paul, 2016.
And with Nathaniel Brown still an unknown factor.
Of course. That is why we're proceeding with our ultimate strategy. You have claimed much in the past, Paige. This is your chance to deliver.
Everything is in place. We can initiate whenever you wish.
I'll secure your communications, Bob. Jaina seems to have eyes everywhere these days. He and his Juggernaut Collective...
Jaina's won't be an issue. I've made arrangements. Well, I laid the foundations. Now it is time to get everyone's attention. Paige, activate the sleep cell.
Sleeper cell, but close enough, sir. But keep that room up for nothing. Why even bother having like a Skype meeting in there? VR Skype. Well, it wasn't Skype because we were hit with ads constantly. Does he intentionally kind of shave his beard like that, like for a cool look, or is it just like, fucked up, but it looks kind of nice? Moodex. Have emotions? Don't! Moodex.
Miller, it's Jensen. Just getting off the train now.
Copy that. We'll debrief when you get in. You coming straight to the office?
Unless there's a problem at a checkpoint.
Your papers should be in order. Just keep your head down. Miller out.
Don't cause any problems. Gotcha. What's the chances of that? Deal with it.
Hold off. Papers, please.
Everything should be in order.
No, I'm afraid they are not. Well,
I'm gonna guess that means hut off equals I can't murder everyone randomly. Random inspection.
Damn, Clank! Why don't you watch where you're going?
Here, let me help you with that, ma'am.
Ma'am? Seriously?
I could have gone with Sweetie. You get my message about Dubai?
Yeah. I'm glad you're all right, Adam. That ambush sounded pretty bad, man.
Not something I was expecting, that's for sure. Any idea who hit us?
I had to reload a lot.
The task force will come up with something, and that it won't be what the Juggernaut Collective digs up. Kind of odd, though, don't you think? Interpol sending your team, the Prague team, to Dubai in the first place?
Miller said they were scrambling. Last minute intel. We were the only strike team available.
Yeah, well, that's a lie.
Welcome to Prague,
Better get moving. The Collective has been keeping tabs on all Task Force divisions ever since we slipped you into one of them. We've got a team in Oman. We've been there a hell of a lot faster than you guys.
So why send us?
I don't know. The Task Force is an Illuminati front, like we all suspect. It doesn't make much sense to send it into an ambush.
Unless they wanted our team to see something.
Here, go.
Officially.
Augumet, připravte si papíry. Připravte si papíry na inspekci.
Don't make a scene,
Adam.
Wouldn't dream of it, Alex.
Don't shove metal arm blades in the throat. Oh, look at that soft skin. Just begging for it. Hey, if he didn't want to be slashed in the throat, he shouldn't have dressed that way. Sup, bitch.
It's gotten even worse here in the past few days.
Coming back for you.
Looking over their shoulder, terrified Oggs like us are going to attack them again.
Somebody probably will. Treat people like animals long enough, they'll start acting like animals.
You say that like there's nothing we could do to stop it.
We should encourage it.
Years ago, it didn't work out so well.
So what? Are you saying we should just give up? Let hatred and prejudice take over? To hell with that!
No, we've replaced the normal humans.
I see, Alex. The men who caused all this, the true power brokers, they're the ones I need to stop. I thought you knew that.
I do. You, me, the Juggernaut Collective, we're all trying to stop them. It doesn't mean turning a blind eye to...
Then help me find them.
Get back in line, sir.
Man, frame rate here is rough.
Hold it! Hand over your papers.
Please, find something out of order so I can open a can of whoop ass.
Just watch yourself, Clank.
Bitch! I swear to Christ, if I wasn't stuck in a auto-moving cinematic.
I hate this city. Come on.
We need to check your papers every 15 feet here. It's
really
annoying.
If you're right about Dubai, about the Illuminati needing your team as witnesses, then we need to find out why.
All right, easy, creeper.
Miller did. But it probably came from someone higher up the chain.
Doesn't mean he's not in on it. Ever heard of the NSN?
A neural subnet, sure. And TF-29 directors use it to plan ops and communicate privately in cyberspace. What's this?
Whisper chip. Custom-made wiretap device. Janus designed it to fit inside the NSN's motherboard.
Ah, the elusive Janus. Leader of the hacktivists. Am I ever gonna meet this guy?
Someday, maybe. Right now you need to concentrate on Miller and find a way to access the NSN's motherboard.
Not a good check in those papers, dude. At some point, I like to draw this session to a close, but...
Alex, you okay?
Yeah. Yeah.
How's my hair, though? Seriously.
Get out of here.
Probably dead. I'm dead! Move on with your life! Now that guy's fine, though.
Please, can you help me?
We can rebuild her.
Stand back, Will.
Oh, that just made it worse. I think you need that. It's pretty dark. Damn it, from one scene to the next. A little something for the ladies. Sup. My augmented six pack.
Hold on.
Ha! Of course, there they go.
Alex, it's Adam.
Hey, you sound like shit. How you feeling?
A little sore, but be all right. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. I've been through worse. Jesus, how fucked up is that to think, huh?
Listen, Alex, my systems are acting up a little, so I've got to get checked out. But if you want to meet or...
What? No, I'm fine, man. You just take care of you. This girl's built tough. Give me a call when you're useful again, okay?
All right, I will. Talk to you soon.
All right. Oof. All right, so that was a fairly long... God damn it!
Lines.
I just wanted to open the blinds.
Good morning, Adam. You have one new message.
From?
David Sarif.
Play it.
Adam, it's David. I know it's been a while, but after what happened in Prague yesterday... Look, son, whatever reasons you've had for not getting in touch these last 2 years, well, life's too short. I'm leaving for London soon, but give me a call.
I got a new voice actor, by the way. I want you to meet him.
You saved his vid call number?
Yes, Adam. Just activate your TV system.
Delete it. Oh, okay. All right, so we're not going to touch anything else, and we're going to quick save. But yeah, that was a long and rough first part, question mark? I'll almost certainly break that into two, because I feel like that was about an hour and a half. But yeah, we're going, and you know, now that I can actually remember to use my abilities and stuff, I think that'll help a lot. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. As always, leave comments in the comment section below. Follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you next time.